Bueno Diaz fans, good morning, hola family. So Ayo Codec is back today with a great tutorial. So before starting the video, I can't keep quiet because Ayo Codec actually made 3,300 subscribers today, and I'm very very grateful for you that took part in this channel. Some of our fans that are found in Pakistan, those of you in India, those of you in the United States, those of you in Brazil, those of you in Cameroon, those of you in Nigeria, those of you in Algeria, and please, for the other countries I have not stated, please, to all of you, and we are very very grateful for what you have done, because actually Ayo Codec is nothing without you guys. So we made 3,300 subscribers today, and I am very grateful. The Ayo Codec is very grateful for you guys. So thank you, thanks again, and let us get into the video today. So in today's video, Ayo Codec actually brought a new playlist. Actually, we actually sat down and thought of what if we can do software reviews. So we're going to be doing now software reviews and verses. But in addition, we still have our daily tricks and tricks that we actually offer, the WhatsApp trick, the Android tricks, the computer tricks, are still going to be part of our video tutorial. Not forgetting the top series, which you are actually going to find someday to actually post video on it. But we just introduced a new playlist where we're going to be talking about, we're going to be constructing some softwares, giving them reviews, looking at some software, flashing them together, which are versus videos. So my last versus video was actually on, I was talking on a versus between some Android emulators, you know, Mimu, Nox Player, and I think, and it was with BlueStack, and that is how we're going to be proceeding from right now. So you can see, yes, a video I made 4 days ago with 56 views, and please, this is a versus video, so each of us have our opinion, but I'm going to look at this at the pros and cons at the end. I'm going to give a final verdict, but feel free to give your own verdict in the comment section. So now let's get into the subject of the day. Today we're going to be clashing two softwares that most of you actually know. We're going to be looking at versus between Google Play Store and AppEpure. So these are two very similar apps in such a way that they are installed, as the name says, they actually stores in which you can get Android application. So now we're going to look in each of them, look at the pros and the cons, and actually now from my point of view, I'm going to determine which one is actually good. And please, on your own case, feel free to leave a comment to actually say which one is the best for you. So Google Chrome is actually, I'm going to start with Google Chrome. Google Chrome is the default app store that comes with your Android device. Each time an Android device is being produced, Google Play Store is already installed by default. So you can see as Google Play Store, as you can all see, their interface is very pretty good, very easy to understand, and the user experience is very very easy. And these are some of the advantages of Play Store, because the interface is very easy. They have actually a large database of apps, which each time the app is produced, it is published on Play Store, and they have a very built-in security, because Google actually takes care of apps that have been published on this platform, which is Google Play Store. So an app can be installed here if it's not risk-free. So an app must be risk-free before Google actually authorizes to be published on Google Play Store. Another advantage of Google Play Store is that all the apps here are actually digitally signed, and there's actually a place like Snapchat. In Snapchat, you can actually go, there's a review section that enables you to actually see the pros and cons of a particular application before downloading them. So that's an advantage. Now, some of the disadvantages of Google Play Store. So Google Play Store actually have some restriction in the sense that of your country location. That is one of the greatest things that Google Play Store actually locate. Google Store actually offers you application based on your location. For example, if you type that some application that you can't actually find them on Google Play Store, because depending on your location, you get an application that are going to tell you that the app is not available in your country. I don't know if some of you have experienced it. So actually, I experienced it last week with one application. That's why I'm actually looking for the application. I don't know if I forgot the name, but there was an app that actually refused to be downloaded in my locality. This is because Google Play Store actually uses their location to give you apps depending on your location. So I think the link of this application is found in the Ayo Codec, so I'm just going to get to it and show you guys what I mean as an example. So let us see. Okay, here's an example. So here's an example of a link, so I'm going to open it with Google Play Store. So if you look at this, Google Play Store actually say your device isn't compatible with this version. Yes, this is true. This is because I'm actually running an old device and my Android version is actually low. But on the other part, that some apps that when you get into Google Play Store, you are going to restrict to have them because of the fact that the app is not available in your country. And another downfall with Google Play Store is that some apps are actually diffused on Google Play Store, even though they might be good for the client, for the users. And an app like ES5 Explorer, which has been actually dismissed from Play Store, even though it has a very good functionality for the users, but it has not been accepted on Play Store because Play Store actually thinks that it goes beyond the user restriction, actually comprises our permission, actually get permission that are not even located for us, that we didn't even accept them. Because yes, Explorer was on Play Store, but it was removed, I can say, last year ago. Yes, was removed. This is because the permission that ES5 Explorer was accepting were too much and actually was above and was already entering the user privileges, so that's why it was removed from Play Store. But ES5 Explorer still remains a very good app for Android users because it's very good. It's a file manager app which actually does many things. So that's it about Play Store. Now let us go on AppSecure. So AppSecure, it is also a very, very good similar app Play Store like Google Play Store. But but what we're going to look is that we're going to be comparing AppSecure to see how it is very good to Play Store. So now our first one I'll start with the advantages of AppSecure. So yes, the user interface of AppSecure, actually it was a website, but they have already developed their application, which actually enables you to have very free access to it. So you can see, to have an app on AppSecure, just use the search bar and actually type the name of the app you are looking for. So you are free to type, if you like, let us say, we're looking for an app, like, let us say, just type the letter and I'm going to start giving you apps. If you say VidMate, you're going to see VidMate already, and you go on the app section and you're going to have the VidMate. Whereas VidMate is not found on Play Store. If I go on Play Store, let us go on Play Store and type back the same VidMate and see, we're going to see that VidMate is not available on Play Store. So if you say VidMate, and you're going to see the difference. VidMate, no results for VidMate. Whereas if you go on the App Store, on AppSecure, you are going to see VidMate. So this is a very clear advantage. A very clear advantage compared to Google Play. This is because VidMate has been restricted by Google Play because it's an app created by the Chinese company, and Google Play actually thinks that it does not have enough security, so it has been dismissed from Google Play Store. And I said earlier, another app like ES5 Explorer, you are still going to find here. If you just say ES5 Explorer, you're going to see find it on this AppSecure. Whereas if you go here, the app, if you go now on Play Store, you're not going to find it. So there's another advantage. The apps that are actually restricted on Google Play, you will find them on AppSecure. Very clear and very productive. Another advantage of AppSecure is that it's true that the user interface is very easy, but that's a downfall with this. No, oops, there's a review section. So you can see the review section is not actually the review section. I forgot. Yes, there's a review section. Just that when you come to the detailed app, normally it's not like Google Play that you're going to see it at this end, but you're going to see there's a tab for it, and there's a group that actually enables users to actually exchange words depending on the file that you see. So yeah, you can see an advantage. The community is very, really good in order to interact with the users that are actually facing some problems, that have some cool things that you can share about the app. But whereas on Google Play, you are not going to have this type of group. You only have the reviews, which actually determine the stars and the comment. But here on AppSecure, you see, you have a group section that allows you to communicate with some of the users of the app that can actually help you if you face a problem while using the application. So one downfall of AppSecure is that actually AppSecure is very limited in terms of the app that I found on AppSecure. Yes, AppSecure is still growing and it's growing every day, but actually right now Google Play remains the most, Google has the most popular app out there, but AppSecure has a limited database in terms of apps. That is why AppSecure is limited. But for the fact that AppSecure actually offers you all the apps that you might think of, and you actually have them, and AppSecure goes in the base that everything on AppSecure is free. That's a very, very great advantage you should actually take note. Because on Google Play Store, not everything on Play Store is free. Google Play Store, you actually have the ability, it's either you buy, so you have a premium section. You can see games here are actually bought, so you can see if you want to install this game, you need to pay last price. You can see there's a premium section on Google Play that allows you that you must actually buy the app before, so you can see, yes, it's $0.26. So you see, yes, another disadvantage. It's true that it's good to buy the app to actually encourage the developer, but some of us don't have the ability to do this. You can actually use AppSecure to have this app for free. So AppSecure goes on the free base functionality. Every app on AppSecure is 100% free. So I think I'm going to leave it at here. Now, looking at the verdict, what is AppSecure going to say? So look at this verdict. Surely most of you will say that the winner is Google Play Store. Most of you will say that Google, the winner is AppSecure. So there are a lot of similar store apps like Google Play, but actually we are looking now at we're just comparing these two. So from a point of view, I'm going to say that AppSecure is the winner of this clash. But now, if you don't actually have, because I told you, each of us have, we all have our different perspective of this app. So feel free to do that in the comment section if you think that Google Play is a winner, or if you think App Store, AppSecure is a winner. And if you have another app, another similar Android, Google Play, Android Store that didn't mention, please, you can actually comment it in the comment below and give your point of view according, because actually there are many other store that you can get Android apps from it, or your Android device. But since in the video I'm just contrasting these two, feel free to mention them in the comment section. And please, on my next video, what I'm going to do, I'm going to be comparing two software, though I'm going to be looking at one of the greatest Google video players used on Windows, which is going to be GOM Player versus VLC. We all know that VLC is the top most used, with one of the top used player in the world, and also have GOM Player, which is also one of the top most used player in the world. So we are going to be constructing this tool, looking at the pros and cons, and actually determine the winner. And please, to the tricks, not better, we always come back, our Google tricks, our Android tricks remain the same. We are still going to be giving some tricks. So if you have any software that you want to contrast, please comment it below. And if you have a trick that you love us to work on, also comment it below. And if you have a series that you wish us to do a video on how to download it, comment it below. So we all wish you a happy weekend, have a nice day, and please remember to subscribe and click on the bell to stay tuned with a notification, and leave a comment if you actually love this video. So bye, see you on IQ Codec. Thank you again for our new subscribers threshold. Bye, see you in my next video.